We recently visited the largest collection of rocks and fossils on public display in Illinois. They're at Augustana College in Rock Island.
We have a 22-foot long theropod carnivorous dinosaur that I found in Antarctica in the early 1990s. It was the first dinosaur ever discovered in Antarctica. It's from a site about 400 miles from the South Pole and at about 12,500 feet of altitude up in the mountains. And this cast is the only cast on display any place in the United States. But we have two new dinosaurs from 2 years ago as well. One of them is almost a complete baby skeleton. So we have a full-time technician working here in my lab on the project.
In this block, we also got a bunch of ribs here and here. We have one coming up this way, a large vertebrae right here, and then probably part of the pelvis up in here. So what I've been working on this block for the last year and a half. Within the quarry, we actually found another dinosaur called Glacialosaurus, which is this kind of long neck precursor they call prosauropods, the early ancestors to the long neck dinosaurs like what they call Brontosaurus.
Today, the Fryxell Geology Museum is one of the largest and finest collections of rocks, minerals, and fossils in the Midwest, of course, outside of the wonderful Field Museum in Chicago. The collections were started in the 19th century by one of our first science professors, Dr. Lindahl, and in 1922, one of our students, now Dr. Fryxell, graduated in 22. He later came back to the college to teach in 24 and developed the geology curriculum and expanded these natural history collections. One of our most impressive displays when you walk through the doors is this giant mosasaur platycarpus. It was a sea serpent that swam and hunted the ancient sea, the interior seaway, that went through the center of North America. Lived about 84 million years ago. These mosasaurs had double-hinged jaws and a double row of teeth on the roof of their mouths, and they would swallow their prey whole. It was found in 1934 during the Dust Bowl by a farmer who was plowing his cornfields in Nebraska. A year after discovering the mosasaur, Mr. Campbell was asked to show his find at a community benefit. And he writes, although the night was a stormy, snowy night and the event wasn't very well publicized, they charged 10 cents and 15 cents per person, and they took in $72 that evening. He says they turned away people at 2 a.m. from the showing. Another impressive display is the Solenhofen collection. It's a wonderful collection of beautifully preserved fossils from Bavaria, Germany, about 150 million years ago. Very fine-grained, limey mud sediment settled in lagoons of ancient seas that covered that area at that time. And we get remarkable preservation, even in our pieces here displayed, like a dragonfly, fish, and jellyfish, which don't usually fossilize. And we also have a rare pterodactyl, a flying reptile. One of our favorite mineral displays for the visitors is the fluorescent mineral display. And you close the curtain and push the red buttons and the rocks fluoresce and glow bright colors. And this is due to an interesting mineral property, a characteristic of only some minerals. We have ultraviolet lights shining on these minerals. They absorb the invisible UV light, and electrons in the atoms of these minerals get excited and they move to different states. And that movement and falling back into their ground state gives off an energy that we see as a glow, as a fluorescent glow. Dr. Fryxell is famous for saying, "True appreciation of landscape comes only when one is alive to both its beauty and its meaning."
To reach the Fryxell Geology Museum, call 309-794-7318 or go to the Augustana College website at www.augustana.edu.